I call this meeting to order at 6:05 p.m. Special meeting of the Isla Vista Community Services District Board of Directors, Thursday, April 20th in the community room. Director Brandt, can you take roll call?
Director Bertrand.
Present.
Director Jordan.
Present.
Director Brandt, I say here. Director Friedman.
Present.
Director Hedges. Director Geis. Director Thurlow.
Here.
Okay, we have a quorum, five members present, with the absence of Directors Hedges and Geis. And also, this meeting is being recorded, just so everyone knows. At this time, if any board members have anything to report, I know at our Tuesday meeting, most of us were able to share some reports. So if there's anything that's changed since then, or if Director Jordan wants to give a report.
The Associated Students has given $3,000 to the internship program. To be clear, I've recused myself from those conversations and actually sat outside while someone else chaired those meetings, so I was not involved, but they did give $3,000. So, also, I got to go speak to a couple potential funders, which was really cool, during a banquet, and I think I might have a couple people who might be interested in helping us out. I will keep you updated. Thank you.
Awesome. Any other board member reports?
No, other than tomorrow at the formation committee meeting, we're going to talk about specific assignments in terms of fundraising. So if you...
What time tomorrow?
It's
3 p.m., I think. I work.
10 o'clock.
I work from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Okay. So we just want to coordinate. if you're talking to people, that then we don't send somebody else to talk to them.
Okay.
And the other thing is, I think it would be great if the board president sent a letter to the Associated Students thanking them for this contribution.
It came directly out of the EVP. Oh, no, it came from Center Unallocated.
Cool. Well, we can't discuss much more. Yes?
Speaking of not discussing much, you must do that coordination at an open meeting and not at the meeting of the formation committee.
Yes. Thank you. All right, now we'll open the public comment. At this time, any member of the public may speak on items under the subject jurisdiction matter of the Board of Directors that are not on the agenda. The Board will not take action on any item not on the agenda except as provided by law. So if it's not about Measure O nor the Sheriff's budget, feel free to speak now. Since there's only a few of us, you can speak from your seat if you have anything to say.
Sure, but since there are so few people, may I have like 7-ish minutes?
No.
How much time are you giving me?
4 minutes.
4 minutes? I can do 4 minutes.
Thank you.
I've been prepared for this eventuality. There's so few people, I don't need that. Ooh. So, I'd like to begin my public comment by playing a little bit of this video of the Formation Committee meeting from 7 days ago. I would like to point out that it is introduced essentially by Geis talking about conflict of interest code.
Well, here's the thing, because I can give you more background on the institution of that policy, what its intention was, and I can tell you that it's meant to be a stopgap policy. It wasn't meant to be the end-all.
Made by the policy committee.
Policy. I really don't think that we can have this discussion, though, because it is not something that's within our jurisdiction as a committee.
Sure it is. Like, all it is a formation activity that the original policy is not sufficient.
The extent to which we can have the conversation is that what you were speaking about, how we don't have, say, a filing officer, the county elections, they don't have anything to file against. So that's as much as item that is a formation item. We really got to be careful with what.
No, we don't. I differ with you.
Yeah. And I disagree with you, Director Thurlow. You do, because you have overlapping committees. If you submit a drafted policy to the policy committee, that is a serial meeting. Moving on.
Could you clarify?
let's talk about that first. Yes. We'll ask questions.
So, first and foremost, I am serving Robert Geis, who is not here, so in his absence, Spencer Brandt, with a violation of the Brown Act, a cease and desist letter. Essentially, during the April 18th meeting, 2 days ago, during... Ooh, I'm going to need that back so that I can say what it was during and all of that. Could I? Okay. During your meeting, two directors, Geis and Thurlow, decided to speak amongst themselves as a quorum of the formation committee to discuss a time that they might meet. The board director didn't quell that discussion. It's a violation of the Brown Act because essentially they created a meeting within a meeting, and you're supposed to notice those. Number two is a cure and correct demand letter. On the 21st of March, you, during item 3.7, considered the creation of a community engagement committee and took action to do so. That was a violation of the Brown Act. You have no substantial limitations for its scope. Essentially, it has continuing subject matter jurisdiction, and it's a violation of the Brown Act. Both of these letters give you a 30-day period within which you can submit what is called a... statement of... So the cure and correct, you have to cure and correct. What I say later on is that you must formally recognize Director Thurlow's motion on item 3.7 was null and void ab initio, that means at the beginning. And for the cease and desist, you must actually, using a format that is given to you within government code, state that this board condemns any discussion without within the purview of a charter of the formation committee during amongst a quorum of its members at a point in time during which that meeting is not noticed. So you must condemn that as a board, vote on it as a separate agenda item during a next meeting of some sort. The final thing is I'm serving you with a Public Records Act request. Also, in the absence of Director Geis, I would like to obtain a document that was passed to a majority of that board during their conversations. I'm entitled to that under the Brown Act. And essentially, it was described as a document that concatenates the goals of the formation committee as presented to the committee by Director Geis during the first meeting of that committee during agenda item 7. That's all I've got. I can take one or two questions.
Thank you. And before any directors may ask questions, which under the Brown Act would have to be very brief, I would personally advise, given the nature of these, that we do not comment nor ask questions at this time.
No questions at all?
I'd recommend against it, but...
never mind then.
Okay. Thank you very much. Any other...
May I ask one question? Sorry. Is this from your lawyer or you?
Myself.
Got it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you give us some complete contact information so that when we retain counsel, we have, besides just a street address, that we also have a...
Sure, my phone number is provided on the PRA request.
Thank you.
Yep.
Any other public comments? Okay, seeing none, we will move along with the agenda. Given that the main discussion tonight is surrounding the sheriff's preliminary budget, and we're really glad that Lieutenant Sindrung could join us, we're just going to go right to that, and we will discuss Measure O after that. So for this, we are going to discuss and consider taking a position regarding the Santa Barbara County Sheriff's preliminary budget recommendations for fiscal year 2017-2018. We're going to discuss the current level of service provided by the County of Santa Barbara in the area of police protection services and review the sheriff's proposed fiscal year 17-18 budget, consider taking a position on the reduction of service, including proposed elimination of 10 full-time equivalents in the Isla Vista Foot Patrol, which we have two attachments that show the recommended budget as of right now, and then also the presentation that was given for the budget workshop. And just to set this up, this came about when Director Thurlow informed the rest of the board at our Tuesday night meeting about the proposed cuts. From there, we decided to have this special meeting to discuss it. One of the eight services of the Isla Vista Community Services District is Police Protection Services. And the reason that that service made it into the district as one of the eight powers was to supplement existing levels of service. Since the existing levels of service may be subject to significant change, we thought it would be appropriate for us to discuss this tonight. So that's just kind of me setting up the conversation. Would any directors like to start off with their discussion, or if they have anything else to kind of frame where we're at? And then from there, we'll have a board discussion and then go out to public comment after hearing from Lieutenant Cintron. Jay.
One thing is to clarify our understanding of this. I watched through the entire public safety budget workshop portion of the supervisor's workshop meeting. And I just want to make sure that we don't mentally frame this too hard on the Sheriff's Department, because
right.
It is the way that the budget workshops work is they explain what would have to be done in order to work within the budget that they're provided. And as part of that, they provided a prioritized list of things that technically they could do, and the undersheriff actually went really far out of his way to say that reduction of the Isla Vista Foot Patrol deputies would be a horrible, horrible thing to do, and that is only on the list because technically at this particular service station, they do have some flexibility, but otherwise they wouldn't even have put it on here. And that they have that and our community resource deputy on their list of restoration expansion requests. So I feel like it is more better to like frame it as the Sheriff's Department, like to support the Sheriff's Department's request in order to maintain the service that is being currently provided in Isla Vista.
Absolutely. Any other board comments before we hear from Lieutenant Cintron?
Yeah.
Lieutenant, if you could share.
It's exactly right. The Sheriff's Department was given a budget target, and along with a bunch of different other options that they had, this is one of those options. It doesn't necessarily mean that this is going to happen. However, it's up on the board in case it does. And the undersheriff wanted me to pass on his gratitude toward you guys regarding your cooperation in case we do need you to go and bat for us. But at this present time, this is just a target is there, so we don't think this is going to happen. So, but it's there just in case it does.
Cool.
Just in case we need to meet that budget cut. The nine bodies along with the community service district, the CRD. Yeah.
And how many deputies are on staff at the Isla Vista Foot Patrol?
We have 12. We have 12 deputies and the CRD and myself. So total 14.
And the 12 deputies, that includes the three patrol sergeants that are?
Correct, that includes everyone. With the exception of the UCPD, they have seven bodies there. One's a sergeant and one's a corporal there.
Okay, so a total of 19
correct.
Officers.
Yeah, 19.
Cool. Any other board questions?
So if the elimination of 10 FTEs would effectively result, or that would mean that a little over half of the law enforcement officers in Isla Vista would be cut?
Correct. A great deal of them, 10
Yeah.
We have 12 out there, so 10 bodies.
Yeah, and almost the entire Isla Vista Foot Patrol unit.
Will be gone,
yes.
Yeah. If it were to happen again, I tell you, this is just one of those things that they use. Okay, if we need to come up with a $2 million cut. What would that look like? It would look like 10 bodies, you know, and we can take them from Isla Vista.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why Isla Vista?
Well, they have not only Isla Vista. On this, they have different targets. They like the air units on here as well.
Right. No, I saw the list, but I'm just curious about why. I mean, you know, you're not going to, I doubt if you're going to eliminate your air support bureau or the school resource and community resource deputy.
Right.
But why, I guess my question is, why use Isla Vista as a bargaining chip in these budget negotiations?
I, I don't sit in those negotiations.
I'm just putting you on the spot. Yeah. But don't worry, we're going to come to bat for you.
Right, yeah. So when I sat in the briefing the other day, and I said, I was not even aware of it, and then I see nine, I said, nine deputies from Isla Vista? That's our entire crew out here. So I wasn't aware. So I don't sit in those negotiations. It's the sheriff and the undersheriff and the command staff. So why Isla Vista, I couldn't really answer that. But I mean, they have different units, that, like the narcotics unit is going to be cut. I believe the gang unit is going to take a hit.
There?
Huh?
There?
DARE? Is that what you asked?
The DARE program?
Yeah. And I think each and every year that we go up for budgets, these are the similar types of things that they always bring up. The Santa Maria jail closing, the Santa Maria jail, that kind of, those are the target things so they can meet the budget requirement. So we'll see where it goes, but like the sheriff said, if we need the support, then we will definitely come to our community partners to ask for that support. But at the present time, it's just, he doesn't think it's going to happen. Like Jay Freeman said, I think he was saying, you listened to that?
Mm-hmm.
So what, I didn't get a chance to listen to it, but that's what I was told.
Do you know where I could find the budget from prior years?
It should be on the county website.
Yep, and it's in our board of documents.
Yeah, you go to the website, it should be all there.
And as far as UCPD providing supplemental officers on weekends,
yeah,
not necessarily as part of the Isla Vista Foot Patrol, is that still ongoing?
Yeah, that's still ongoing. They have seven bodies that help us out there, and they're part of the IV Foot Patrol.
Okay, but like on weekends, do they send any additional officers in?
They'll have their guys on campus, but they do come out because of all the other properties that are on, and they come into Isla Vista and help out when we need them.
But there was a surge. They had a strategy.
Yes.
They surged officers in here.
Right.
I think that's your question.
That is, yeah.
Right. That was last year. I don't know if they're still doing that. And they were doing it like during Deltopia. I think they had quite a few people out here. But that was you called it a surge. I forget what they called, like a saturation type where, yeah. But I don't think they're doing that anymore. But
got it. Okay. Any
they
more?
Haven't told me that they were doing that. They usually communicate that with me.
Got it. Any more questions for the lieutenant? Yeah.
Is this the first time that the Isla Vista Foot Patrol unit has been put on the chopping block in this kind of a way?
I couldn't even answer that. I wasn't here last year.
I don't think so. I think this has happened.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I know for a fact that the Santa Maria jail, they ended up closing that down, which at one point, just to save money, which caused all the other agencies up north to have to transport all of their prisoners down to the main jail here.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I'm not certain that this is the first time, but you don't think it has been.
So in support, to borrow your language, Jay, unless you want to make the motion. I think our motion would be to move to support the Sheriff's Department's budget request that the Isla Vista Foot Patrol be added in as the, what did you call it? There's a word.
It's a restoration.
Restoration
request. Yeah.
So that we support the Sheriff's Department's request for restoration of the Isla Vista Foot Patrol.
I'll second that.
So support the sheriff's. And Lieutenant, what's the proper term? Sheriff's office or sheriff's department?
Sheriff's office. It used to be the sheriff's department, and I think a few years ago they went away from that.
Got it.
Because he's an elected official, it's the sheriff's office.
Sheriff's office. So motion to support the sheriff's office's funding restoration request. And is there any direction that wants to be given to that? to submit a letter to appear before
yes,
the supervisors.
That we direct the board president to inform the board of supervisors of this action.
Great. And how it's written here is to inform the Board of Supervisors on our position. Is that friendly with the first and second?
Friendly.
Okay. Public comment on the motion? Any board comment? All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions? So ordered, 5-0.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Absent. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Our pleasure. All right.
All right, quick. Let's do the dessert.
This is so cool.
Let's go. So after just talking about this with various people, because I am funding...
We're still in this...
Oh, I.
So I just was wondering where in the agenda we were.
The thing is, I'm going to recuse myself from this next agenda item.
Oh, okay.
And the transition between these agenda
items.
Are we done with item 3.2? Was there anything else we wanted to discuss within that?
Yeah, just let me know where we are.
Well done. Okay, then we'll move to 3.1. You're saying that you're recusing.
I'm recusing myself after discussing this with various people because I'm funding essentially over a third of the Measure O campaign currently, and probably will be funding something like a half of it. I got a couple people who said that I should recuse myself, and that was also my thought as well, because it starts to feel like I'm just in a bunch of things. So,
right,
thank you. All right, Jay.
Can you please take note of that in the minutes that Jay left the room at this time, whatever time it is? Thank you.
Right out here, so you can get me.
Thank you.
Just to be clear, he left the room. I just like to make sure that we're very clear on that.
And then let's real quick just talk about our other involvement in this to see if there's any conflict.
Mm-hmm.
I've been a big proponent of Measure O. I was off the park board at the time that it was placed on the ballot, though I've been very much involved. It's been something that I've definitely been personally dedicated to.
That's as long as you're allowed to be passionate about things, correct? You're
mm-hmm.
allowed to have passion
yeah.
as long as you're not financing it or it doesn't affect you.
Haven't financed it.
Other than Lovely Parks, which affects all of us, right?
Yeah.
Beautiful parks.
Yeah, I mean, the gain of it passing that I would get would be the same as anyone else in Nova Vista.
Okay,
so,
then there's...
Right. Is there anyone else who feels... Because you've obviously...
No, I volunteered involved. For the campaign. I've helped them with their field operation to an extent, but that is not a conflict of interest.
Well, you know what? But here would be my question. I'm an author on the argument for support.
I saw that you did write on it.
It's okay.
The conflict
of
interest
it's
not financial.
They've got to
be financial.
It can also be perceived. A conflict
right.
of interest can be
no.
perceived. No,
they
it's
don't,
not just
financial. They're not just financial. There's
a conflict of interest is also a perception or a personal impact, which can also be in the form of a gift if it like is within 500 feet of your house. So if you live within a certain range of a park, you could technically be in a little pickle.
You know, being that I am an author on the ballot argument, I think I would need to...
I don't know if we have quorum then to be able
we
to
don't,
vote on
but
it.
I don't. I think that since that's a question and since I've been open about that, I think I need to find out more before I was to go forward with it. And I'm really sorry that I didn't think of that before getting to this meeting. With that in mind, I will either recuse myself from this discussion,
actually, let's see. No, the quorum is established with 5 members.
So even here?
So there is a quorum.
Once he recuses himself.
It has to be a half and then plus one. 50%
right.
plus one.
The full board of the number of the board members that are present for the meeting. What's Robert's rule say? A quorum?
Well, we're...
Does a quorum...
A quorum consists of the members who are... the total members, half... half plus one is quorum.
But I do believe that once you establish quorum, that the majority can still vote on matters, even if you don't still have that. So I'll let one of you look that up.
Yeah. I think it would be better for us to err on the side of caution on that one, and take this up at a separate meeting. So,
I don't. I mean, yeah. Agree. I don't think that you're writing a ballot measure would mean that you have a conflict of interest. It simply means that you've supported.
May I share a document?
Already the ballot measure, and yeah, go ahead.
May I share a document from the California Attorney General's Office of Conflict of Interest?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, let me find the exact passage that on this area. It'll just be one moment. It's like 200 pages. Mm. Sorry. So it's direct involvement interest, correct? I could share this with each of you through
you, you
via
can't
email.
Actually do that while we're at this meeting.
Oh, never mind.
Yeah.
Let me check.
I believe that you can.
Look it up.
The Brown Act just states, I don't think you have to have an attachment noticed by the Brown Act. So essentially, she can pass this out, but you have to have it open to public record act request.
Right.
After
but I mean, given the current discussion, I don't think we should send things around electronically just because of how some things.
Fine.
I'm just saying, I don't think it's a problem for her to read it to us.
Let me just find the
That's
article. It's just 200
fine.
Pages, so I have to find the right
so
passage,
just read it,
which could take
share.
A hot minute. Sorry.
You're fine.
But I, you know, again, while you're looking for that, Ethan, I have never heard of a situation where somebody who promotes something. I mean, you could say the same thing if you wrote a letter to the editor
right.
supporting this. I mean, you've publicly stated that you're in support of it. Most people on this board
okay.
have publicly stated they're in support of it. So I don't see that your writing on the ballot measure would in any way be anything more than you publicly supporting this measure.
I don't know if this is applicable, but appearance of financial conflict according to common law, court made law based avoiding actual impropriety of the appearance of impropriety in the conduct of government affairs may require that government officials disqualify themselves in participating in decisions which there may be an appearance of financial conflict of interest. Even if it appears that way, I don't know if that applies, but let me just find
well,
out the other
so
way.
I don't,
think
I don't have any I don't have any financial.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let me find here. The Declaration of the Foundation of Conflict of Interest provises public officials, whether elected or appointed, should perform their duties in an impartial manner, free from bias caused by their own financial interests or the financial interests of persons who have supported them. Further, the Act sets up a mechanism whereby assets and incomes of the public officials may be materially affected by their own official actions are disclosed. Inappropriate circumstance by the official disqualification and acting in other, in order that conflicts of interest may be avoided. So it's, this one seems much more financial based.
Right.
Let me see if there's anything else. Unless you're using your position in the influence of making a governmental decision.
Everything we do here
so
is that.
So I would recommend that you abstain on the vote.
Then I have to abstain on the discussion.
No.
No.
Well, to comply with the Political Reform Act, you need to recuse yourself from both the vote and the abstention. So if it is something that I have to recuse myself
well,
from.
Well, no. I'm just saying it. No, I'm saying that I don't believe that you have to recuse yourself because there's no financial conflict of interest here. All you've done is express your First Amendment right, which any person can do in terms of writing a ballot measure. You get no direct conflict. You know, there's no financial. So, I mean, you're gonna tie us all up where any public comment that we make in support of something would then mean that we could no longer support that as a board member. And it seems like pretty soon you can't do anything. So
no.
I'm not, again, not a lawyer, not licensed in California.
The requirement to announce a conflict and leave the meeting has to do with the decision that necessitates disqualification under the Act must arise under procedures. Okay, so basically it says that it has to do that he or she has financial interest in that decision and necessitates that the disqualification of the Act. That's all I'm finding.
Yeah. All right.
If you don't feel comfortable, that's the most important part. If you don't feel comfortable, let's move to it later. Let's figure out more information. You know? I don't know. I don't want you to feel uncomfortable with the situation.
Right. Well, my thought is that since I don't feel clear about it,
okay.
I don't think we can.
Okay. Then I would move that we adjourn the meeting.
All right. Do we have a second?
Wait, we have to move to that agenda item, or do we not have an agenda item tonight? Do you have an agenda item?
Well, I mean, that's procedurally, that was fine what they did.
Okay. I was just wondering.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we were on that agenda item.
Okay.
And Jay recused himself, and then we had this discussion, and then we're going to open it to the public before we make a motion to adjourn.
My personal opinion is that there is no conflict of interest.
Thank you.
So move to adjourn.
A second. All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Any abstentions? So ordered. 4-0. Hedges absent. Geis absent. Jay Freeman.
He can.
Outside.
We should have called him in for the vote on adjournment. And
this meeting was adjourned at 6:36 p.m.